Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Love Starter. If you have a Shopify store and you're running Google Ads campaigns, then it's super important to be able to see the value your ads are generating. It lets you report on performance and optimize your campaigns. So today I'm going to show you how to track conversions and conversion value in Google Ads from your Shopify store. To send revenue values to Google Ads, we're going to use Google Tag Manager and a custom data layer in Shopify. However, another option is to install the Google Channel app. So if you'd like to see me cover this option in a future video, please let me know in the comments below. Okay, let's start by heading to Shopify. I've already implemented Google Tag Manager on my demo store, so let's take a look at how I've done this. Let's select Online Store. Now let's select Actions for the theme and choose Edit Code. Now I'm going to select the theme.liquid file. This is where the Google Tag Manager container has been added. Now let's close this and let's select Settings and then Checkout and Accounts. Now let's scroll down to the Order Status Page section. Here we can see a custom data layer that captures details about the transaction, along with the Google Tag Manager container code. So Google Tag Manager is already implemented on my demo store. For an in-depth walkthrough of how to add Google Tag Manager to your Shopify store, I've included a link to my dedicated tutorial in the description below this video. Okay, now let's head to Google Tag Manager. And let's select Tags. We can see there is already a GA4 Google Analytics 4 Ecommerce tag, so let's select this. We can see this is an event tag, and the tag includes a number of Ecommerce parameters to send information to GA4. We can see items, transaction ID, value, and so on. I need to highlight that there is a new way to capture e-commerce details. Instead of creating all of these separate parameters, we can now enable the option to automatically capture all of this information from the data layer. So let's head to another Google Tag Manager container that uses this option. Let's navigate to Tags again and select the GA4 e-commerce tag. We can see this tag uses the Send e-commerce data option, so all of the available e-commerce information is automatically sent to GA4. If you're using this option, then you might need to create a new variable in Google Tag Manager to capture the details. So let's close the tag. And let's select Variables. Since I can't see any existing variables for e-commerce value, transaction ID, or currency, we're going to create them. Let's click New. Let's name the variable e-commerce value. And let's select Variable Configuration. Now let's choose Data Layer Variable. And for the data layer variable name, let's enter ecommerce.value. And let's save the variable. Now let's create another variable. Let's name the variable ecommerce transaction ID. Let's select Variable Configuration. Choose Data Layer Variable. And enter ecommerce.transaction_ID as the data layer variable name. And let's save the variable. Now let's create one more variable. Let's name the variable ecommerce_currency. Let's select Variable Configuration. Choose Data Layer Variable. And enter ecommerce.currency. And let's save the variable. Now it's time to create our Google Ads conversion tag. So let's select Tags. And let's create a new tag. Let's name the tag Google Ads Ecommerce. And let's select Tag Configuration. Now let's choose Google Ads Conversion Tracking. At the top, we can see an alert telling us the conversion linker tag is missing for our container. So let's click Create. Let's name the tag Google Ads Conversion Linker. This extra tag helps ensure that details about clicks from our Google Ads campaigns is stored in first-party cookies. Let's save the tag. Now we need to enter our conversion ID and conversion label from Google Ads. So let's head to Google Ads. Now let's select Tools and Settings, and then Conversions under Measurement. Since there is no existing conversion action for purchases, let's create a new conversion. We need to enter the URL of our website. And click Scan. Now let's scroll down and select Add a conversion action manually. Let's select Purchase as the category. Let's leave the name as Purchase. Now let's choose Use different values for each conversion. And I'm going to enter 0 as the default value. This will mean that if the conversion tag fires without a value, then we won't be reporting a value. I'm going to leave the rest of the default options selected. And let's scroll down and click Done. Now let's click Save and Continue. And let's select the Use Google Tag Manager tab. We can now copy the conversion ID and conversion label. And let's head back to Google Tag Manager. Now we need to paste the conversion ID into our tag. And let's paste the conversion label. Now we're going to use the variables we created earlier. Under Conversion Value, let's select the variable icon. And let's select e-commerce value. Let's do the same for transaction ID, but this time let's select the e-commerce transaction ID variable. And let's select the variable icon for the currency code. And select e-commerce currency. Now let's scroll down and select Triggering. If you already have a trigger for purchases, then you can select your existing trigger. Since I don't have one in my Google Tag Manager container, let's click the plus sign to create a new trigger. Let's name the trigger e-commerce purchase. Let's select Trigger Configuration. And choose Custom Event as the trigger type. Now let's enter Purchase as the event name. And let's save our trigger. And save our tag. We've now created a Google Ads conversion tag in Google Tag Manager that will send purchase details to Google Ads. You can now preview your container to test that the new tag works as you expect. And then when you're ready, you can click Submit to publish the tag, trigger, and variables to your live website. If you're already using Google Tag Manager on your Shopify store, then using the existing information in the data layer is a great way to send purchase details to Google Ads. And you can even reuse the variables we created for other third-party conversion and tracking tags. Are you going to use Google Tag Manager to set up Google Ads conversion tracking? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. And if you found this video helpful, please like it so I know to make more videos like this one. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.